Alright, so for this video, I'm going to show you some of the mistakes people make when working with the proportions of face. I'm not a professional artist, but trying to get there, so I have some experience with this. One of the things that it's very common for people to do is they create a head that looks like a bean. Some people might have a head like that, but here's where the a lot of the issues show up. They tend to draw the eyes on the forehead. So you things like that, then of course I'm exaggerating, a lot of people don't do this, but this is very common, especially with early drawers or people who are beginning to work on the drawing skills. And a lot of times do what I like to call a peanut mouth. Okay, so reminds me of a peanut mouth, but there are certain proportions that that are easy to remember, that help you place parts of the face in the right spot. Okay, now this is not going to be a final drawing. This is just going to be a drawing showing the proportions. Usually, I start with a circle. That is not the head, and that's part of the whole head. So that will be the top part of the head. Make it a little bit darker so you can see better on the camera. Okay, and there's another part underneath that looks, that completes the rest of the face. This is more of an oval shape. This is where you will draw the jaw and the rest of it. And like I said, this is just a quick, very informal approach to drawing. Okay, this is going to be more about the proportions of the face rather than a quality final drawing. Okay, so when you think about drawing the face, you got to think about the distance between this and this as the whole head, not just the face, the whole head. Okay, now our eyes tend to be more or less around halfway between the top of the head and the bottom of the chin. So I'm going to draw a guideline, and that's going to give you about half of a head. Then I also like to make a line in the middle for reference. Okay, so that's about half of my head both ways, horizontal and vertically. Now the eyes are usually placed around this area right here. So you want to do, this is more or less the area where your eyes are going to be. Now, to place the eyes proportionally, you want to divide this distance in approximately 5 equal parts. Okay, some people have bigger eyes, some people have smaller eyes. There's variations in the heads, but in general, more or less, this is what you're looking at. So you have about 1/5, 1/5, 1/5, 1/5, 1/5. Okay, and then this is where the eyes go, on the 2/5. Okay, they're more like almond shape rather than beanie shape. Now, like I said, there's many variations, so depending on. Okay, so this is mostly about the proportions of the face and not necessarily about a final design. Okay, now to draw the nose is about 1/3 between the eyes and the bottom. About everything is about this far, about this long, about this, because it's different for each person. But it's a good way of keeping track of the proportions. So your nose is going to be about right here. Tend to draw a nose by doing 3 little circles. And then that would be my placement for the nose. There's a nose bridge right here, depending on how visible you want to make that. Now, these are not my favorite eyes that I've drawn, so I'm just going to Making a little bit just to kind of complete the. And then the mouth is between this and that area. Now, don't make a very long mouth. It's this much, depending on the person, once again. Now, the lip at the bottom doesn't really connect to the edge of the mouth. And then, some people like to create these guide circles. You don't have to, but for some people it works. And then you can do a little bit of shading as you go. Okay, but don't connect this to this. This is actually a very noticeable line, but it starts fading as the lips get, as this part of the lips gets closer to that. Then from here you can start adding changes in. Okay, so anyway, so these are a quick lesson on the proportions of the face. Okay, there's more to it. There's the ears and the cheekbones and there's the hair. Okay, ears usually go from this part to this part right here, from the eyes. We humans tend to have our proportions larger than what we think. And then you can put your hair right there. Anyway, so you can take your, start doing your shading as you want, okay? Anyway, so that's all I'm gonna present to you.